in 10 years, I should not be rapping. On to a different career, on to some different shit. So no, I shouldn't be rapping in about 17 years.
Kentrell DeSean Gaulden, a.k.a. NBA Youngboy, was born on the 20th of October in 1999. Currently, he's one of the brightest rappers on the scene, but still seems to be getting in an awful lot of trouble. While fans hope for Youngboy's sake that he breaks free from the Louisiana rapper's curse, his own actions are diminishing that hope. It's been alleged before by the insiders that rappers involve themselves in criminal activities to gain clout, but in NBA's case, the involvement has gone too far. Today, his charge sheet is longer than his hit songs list, and his crimes are only getting bigger with each passing year. It started with him getting arrested for petty robberies and getting sentenced to juvie, but today he's been arrested by the FBI, and with each passing day, it's getting tough for him to get out of this web he weaved. In this video, we'll take a look at Youngboy's most toxic moment, which even made it difficult for his fans to stand him. Before we get started, make sure to leave a like and comment on this video. Why do you think Youngboy acts so reckless? Is it just to gain clout, or is he actually a doomed cause? Also, if you'd like to join this month's giveaway of a brand new iPhone 12, then all you have to do is subscribe to the channel and watch this video until the end to find and comment the hidden message. Good luck! Engaged in internet war with his mother. NBA may be a lot of things, but he's definitely not a dutiful son. Well, we aren't saying that his mother is. The death-inclaimed rapper has gone on record to say that his mother was not a part of his childhood, at least not a pleasant part. After hearing this, his mother responded by saying it's untrue, and to this, Youngboy replied that she's just doing this for attention. He wrote in his story, "You want attention you not finna get." Gaulden's mother didn't reply with anything after this, but it's safe to say that their relationship is anything but good. Beef with G-Money. Rappers are known to have feuds with rival artists, but even then there's some protocol to follow if someone dies. Clearly, Gaulden doesn't believe in showing courtesy. He's always had issues with G-Money, especially after they fell apart. But then after Money died, Gaulden made a whole song. You can bet the song wasn't to celebrate his life. In fact, it was doing the exact opposite. This was a toxic moment for the whole rapping community, as it showed rappers are some heartless monsters who can't stop fighting even after someone dies. Mockery of suicide. Gaulden has repeatedly talked about killing himself. He's tweeted several times and given multiple dates to his fans. Every time he said something like this, it obviously made his fans really worried. But later, instead of giving any justification, he would treat it like a joke. While this humor of his may seem harmless, but it adds to people not taking mental health seriously. His tone is mocking the suicidal thoughts that many depressed people deal with on a regular basis. While it's a great thing that he himself is not actually doing whatever he's saying, but he's really not providing any benefit to the people who struggle with their inner demons. Shooting at people. In November 2016, right before his show in Texas, NBA was arrested for opening fire at some people at South Baton Rouge Street. The police held his bail on a $200,000 bond. When NBA got a chance to tell his side of the story, he said that just because he's a famous name, he's the easiest one to trap. He hinted that it wasn't him who actually shot, but he was the one the police decided to put in handcuffs. He told a hip-hop publication magazine, "I don't think they really target, but if you got a name, they know who you is. You do something, they're gonna come get you, and whoever you're with and whatever they do, you're accountable for it just because you got the biggest name. That's how that shit goes." While his fan base is extremely loyal, this time, even they couldn't defend him. From his own statement, it's clear that he was hanging out with the wrong crowd, and may have even been tempted to do something to show his edge. In 2017, he eventually took the plea deal, which had one count of assault with a firearm. Arrested on kidnapping charges. In February 2018, Youngboy was arrested on three charges: kidnapping, weapon violations, and assault, before he was about to go on stage in Florida. According to TMZ, he had assaulted his then-girlfriend Jania Jackson, and the hotel surveillance footage was the video proof of their physical altercation. At the beginning of the video, it looked like they were screaming at each other, but then Youngboy roughly pushed her to the ground. The surveillance camera caught all this, and when the police were shown the video, they immediately arrested him. After his arrest, Jania tweeted that his boyfriend had never hit her. Even this didn't get him out of jail, as the video footage clearly shown NBA assaulting someone, even if it wasn't his girlfriend. He was then released from jail on a bond of $75,000. Miami shooting. In 2019, when Youngboy was on probation, his name came on top in another heinous crime. He was accused of opening fire after someone targeted his girlfriend. The shooter injured his girlfriend and killed an innocent civilian, who was close by. While the charges were quickly dropped, it soon became evident that he wasn't alone. He was hanging out with his allies Ben Fields and Trulondrick Norman. This was enough to show that he's violated the condition of his probation, and the court then banned him from performing for the whole year. Involvement in drug peddling. In 2020, police arrested 16 people for drug and weapon manufacturing in Louisiana. He was mainly charged with the manufacturing and distribution of drugs. His lawyer tried his best to prove that when he was arrested, his client didn't have anything in his possession. But looking at his history, the judge wasn't convinced with the narrative his lawyer was trying to sell. Running away from the FBI. He was also being named for having stolen dangerous firearms. In 2021, federal agents had a warrant to arrest him for being involved in the use of K-9. His vehicle was stopped by the police, and upon seeing the warrant, he decided to run on foot but was eventually caught. After this, he deactivated all of his social media accounts, and to many fans, it seems that his criminal side has finally overshadowed his once promising career. And with this, we've come to the very end of this video. Tell us in the comments below which young boy moment do you think is the most toxic. Let us know your thoughts on the whole video below. Also, don't forget to leave a like on this video, and if you're new to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button for all future content. Thanks for watching, until next time.